वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द हिस्ट्री सब्जेक्ट लेसन नंबर 5. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन द बुद्धिज्म. इन बुद्धिज्म वी हैव सीन द नोबल ट्रूथ, द एटफोल्ड पाथ एंड इज एसेंस ऑफ टीचिंग. टुडे वी विल सी द जुडाइज्म. पीपल बिलोंगिंग टू द ज्यूविश रिलीजन may have arrived in Kochi in Kerala around the 1st to 3rd century of the Christian era. So these people belong to the Jewish religion and they arrived in Kochi, that is in Kerala, in 1st to 3rd century of Christian era. They believe that there is only one God. So in this religion they believe that there is only one God. Judaism emphasized, means it gives the importance, that is to justice, truth, peace, love, compassion, humility, charity. Here, charity means what, students? To help or raise the money for the needy people. That is the charity. Ethical speech. That speech should be very cool, clear, and self-respect. Their prayer house is known as synagogue. So the people they do the prayer. That house is known as a synagogue. This is a synagogue. In your textbook, the picture is also shown. Next is the Christianity. Christianity is the religion founded by Jesus Christ. Can you see in this picture, student? It has spread all over the world. Saint Thomas, one of the 12 disciples of Christ, came to Kerala in the first century of the Christian era. He established a church at Palayur in Thrissur district in 52 CE. So this is a church in Thrissur district. According to the teaching of Christianity, there is only one God. He is the loving father of all and is the omnipotent. Ye omnipotent means what, students? Having the unlimited powers or great powers. It is believed that Jesus Christ is the Son God. So people believe that Jesus Christ is the Son God who came to earth for the salvation of mankind, for the saving of mankind. The Jesus Christ, that the Son of the God, came to the earth. According to the teachings of Christianity, we all are brothers and sisters. We should forgive those who err or go wrong. So we should forgive the people, those who do the wrong thing. The Bible is the holy book of Christianity and the prayer house is known as a church. So the holy book of Christian people is the Bible and the prayer house is known as church. So this is the church, student. In your textbook, picture is also shown. Next is Islam. Islam is a monotheistic religion. Here monotheistic means what, student? Means there is only one God in their religion. And which is, there is only one Allah and Muhammad is his prophet. Prophet means what? A person regarded as an inspired teacher is known as a prophet. The message of God is revealed through him in the holy book of Quran Sharif. So whatever the message of God is, that it is in the holy book and the name of the book is Quran Sharif. The word Islam means peace. What does the word Islam means? A peace. It also means surrender to Allah. The teaching of Islam is that Allah is eternal. Allah is eternal, absolute, all-powerful and merciful. He is very kind. The purpose of human existence is to worship Allah. So what is the purpose? Means to worship the Allah. The Quran Sharif provides guidance on how man should behave in life. So what is there in the holy book of that Quran Sharif? It is that provide a guidance on man how should believe, how one should a man should believe in his life. See, in ancient time there have been trade relations between India and Arabia. Arab traders used to visit the ports on the coast in coast on Kerala. So this Arab traders also used to visit on the coast of Kerala. Islam spread in Arabia in the 7th century. And when they spread in Arabia, students, in 7th century, see, Islam arrived in India in the same century through the Arab traders. So when they arrived, when the Arab traders arrived in Islam, arrived in India. The prayer house of Islam is known as the mosque or masjid. So where they doing the prayers, na students, that place is known as mosque or the masjid. So this is the masjid. Next we will see the Zoroastrianism. Zoroastrianism. See, in ancient times, the Zoroastrian people and Vedic people have shared ties. So they were both were attached to each other. The sacred text of the Parsis or the Zoroastrian people is the Avesta. So whatever the text is there of the Parsi people and the Zoroastrian people is the Avesta. The language of the Rig Veda and Avesta is similar. So whatever the language is there, they are similar. The Parsis came to India from the Pars or Fars province of Iran. So from where do they came, the Parsis people, to? They came to India. Province means what? The area of the Iran. Therefore, they are known as the Parsis. It is mostly believed that they first came to Gujarat in the 8th century CE. So it was believed that they came to Gujarat. Zarathustra or Zoroaster was the founder of their religion. Ahur Mazda is the name of their god. So what is the name of their god, students? That is Ahur Mazda. The elements of fire and water are very important in their religion. So two main aspects are very important in their religion. They are the fire and water. The sacred fire burns in the temple, which are known as Agyaris. So the fire which was burned in the temple, it was known as the Agyaris. At the core of Parsi thinking are three main principles of conduct. So according to them, there are three main principles, namely, which are they? Good thoughts, good words and good deeds. Agyari. So this is the place where the fire is being born. Hope so, students, you might have understood the full chapter very well. Try to go through the textbook. Try to have a self-reading. Try to find out the hard words with the help of dictionary. So it will be very easy for you. Everything I had given of this chapter in PDF form. Have a practice of question answers without seeing. So I am ending this full chapter here only. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.